Hey, Shubidoodlers, how are you doing? I went to a country house recently and picked up all these beautiful liquid amber leaves, and I was going to draw them there and then when I got home, but they've all gone a bit dry. But I have drawn this one, and I've drawn these ones too while I've been thinking about it and practicing. And I'm going to show you how to do that now, but let's not talk about it. Let's do it. Well, these really are very beautiful leaves, and they're beautiful colours in there as well. We've essentially got this sort of creamy, ochre-y kind of base colour with pink on top and then a very sort of dark purpley brown as well. That's kind of what I've tried to do here. And working this out, this one's probably a bit easier to see. They've all really curled up. Look, they just snap apart. but we got this one vertical, and then these are pretty much going at 45 degrees. And then these are pretty much going just a little bit more than 90 degrees, sort of down that way. So that's what we're going to work on. Get all these leaves out of the way. So I'm treating myself today to a nice piece of paper. This is Langton Mould Made watercolour paper. And this is £140, 300 GSM, hot press smooth. Now that's what I like. So I've got this nice piece of paper, I just cut a little piece out, and I like it smooth because I do a lot of work for illustration and stuff which has to be scanned. If it's got too much of a surface and a texture to the surface, it's very hard to get a really good scan. So I like my paper to be quite smooth. So I'm going to start with a line going out there. And I'm going to work out roughly, that's about 45 degrees. That's about 90 degrees. So I want this to be coming out about 45 degrees. This one is really curving down. That's a much smaller one. But these are pretty much going straight out at 90 degrees. And they're actually coming out as a kind of a branch of those ones. So I'll have it just slightly lower than 45 degrees like that. And they want to be kind of the same width. So these are sort of coming out here, maybe a little bit further, but pretty much the same width out as these are going up there. You can't see this at all, can you? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press that a little bit harder, bring that up there, because I don't want to press hard on the pencil because it's going to be erased when I've done the ink. If you press too hard, you cannot erase the pencil lines. So I'm going to put a little line about there, a little dot there, and another one about there, just as a kind of a target. And then I'm going to draw these kind of curves. So that's going to come out to there, and then this will come out. And I want them to have that little bit of a, bring them in a bit at the end, kind of like a candle flame, I suppose. It's coming pretty much straight out, curving in and then curving out again. And then that can do something similar there. And that's sort of curving down there. Now here, this wants to come out in a nice little, it's a quarter circle really. And then that will come and join up at the end there. I have no idea if you can see any of this. It's very light drawing on the paper. So what I'm going to do now is draw these with this zigzag to get the zigzag edge. And we want to get that round there a little bit, and then we can do this similar here. Just following around like that. And normally I tape things down, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to leave this fairly free so that I can roll the paper around, which is far more natural, like that. And then here we're going to go, it's this kind of smooth zigzag. Take your time, don't rush it. This wants to come around in a quarter circle, and then like back on yourself, these little zigzags. There we go. Yeah, so I got these leaves from a place called Wire Park in Worcestershire. We went off to meet my brother-in-law and his lady wife 2-3 weeks ago, And it was pouring with rain. We had other plans. And then eventually we thought, where can we go now? So we saw this place, Wire Park. And it's a beautiful capability, brown landscape, lakes and choice trees and grottos and things like that. And it was just very, very lovely. And the rain stopped and everything just worked out really nicely. And then sort of towards the end of our walk, as we were going around the lake, the top lake, there was this beautiful liquid amber tree, which is all one word, liquid amber, apparently. and so we picked up these leaves. And I thought, oh, I'm going to draw those. And so they've all got a little bit dry. So I'm going to draw this vein coming down there very lightly, and that sort of comes out as this is branching, this one here. So I'm going to do that, kind of branching out there, and then I turn that around a bit, and now that's going to then branch out across to there. Oh, these leaves, they want to join in. And then that is kind of coming up there and coming out there, so that'll give it a bit of a thickness at the beginning, kind of like the trunk of it, and then that's going to come up to there, and then that will just kind of fade out. Good. Now, the next bit, we want to do these sort of side veins, so they're going to be curving up like that. If we do one side first, and then the next one is just slightly staggered, going up that way, and then we can work out where that one's going to start, round about there, and there we can go there. So this will be slightly staggered again, and here I'll do that one coming up to there, and I'm not connecting them here, the lines, I'm just kind of to one side, and this is just slightly staggered up there, curving up nicely, and then this will want one major one sort of coming up there, and again we want that sort of coming up there. I'm slightly increasing the angle as I'm going. I'll do that from there, I think, and again here, that's there. And again, slightly staggered. We'll want one coming from about there and there too. These are ones I did earlier in my sketchbook. I've been thinking an awful lot recently about the kind of drawings and watercolour painting ins that I show you on this channel. And I've come to the conclusion the thing is to really go for this ink outline and simple painting in, because this all gets really, really complicated. So that's what I'm going to be doing. And this is going to blow all the leaves everywhere. So I'm going to dry this now. And that is just to make sure that the ink is dry before I erase all those pencil lines. And I'm trying to do that fairly gently, because if you press too hard in the first place, you're not going to be able to erase them. And the harder you erase, the more you're going to scuff up the surface of the paper, and it's just not going to work properly for you. So be gentle with your surface and try not to get sticky, grubby, greasy fingerprints on either. That's not good. So this is all about keeping it wet. This is where a better quality watercolour paper is really going to help. And this is Naples yellow I'm using there, with a little bit of, I don't know what this yellow is. Some people will show you watercolour and they're kind of obsessed with the actual colours that you're using. And I suppose I should be too, because they do actually have a kind of a chemical reaction with each other, some of them, and they work different ways and they sort of blend in different ways. But I've never got into that. I just think, oh, that's yellow. I suppose I'm just a bit literal about that, which is why I suppose also that I'm kind of doing it in this simplistic kind of way, and not doing it really, really complicatedly in sort of, I suppose, traditional watercolour techniques. This is simple. This is complicated simple. Okay, so you know, simple would be just leaving it like that, but we are actually wanting to do a little bit more than that. So I want to really keep this wet, so it doesn't hurt to add some more paint on there and liquid and keep it flowing. And this is where you're going to be tested, is to keep it nice and wet. Now I'm using this, it's a kind of a carmine. It isn't actually carmine, so it's I could probably find out and put it in the comments below, in the description below. And I'm going to go along the edge, and I'm just going to kind of bring it into these little areas as well, like that. And can you see how it's flowing? Because it's nice and wet, and that is the secret. This is wet on wet technique, and we'll just kind of bring that into these little areas in between the ribs, like that. And we just want to keep this wet. I'm just going to pause this for a moment because I've had a thought. This technique is quite complicated. And I thought, how would it be if I did live webinars showing you how to do this so that you can follow along and you can shout and tell me, stop, you're going too fast, that kind of thing. I'm going to put a little poll up in the top here so you can say yes or no. I'm also going to put a link to my website, shoerainer.com. Go there and sign up for an email. And then if I decide to do that, then you'll know when I'm going to do it. My wife used to be a big wet fan. You may have never heard of wet. They were a pop group in the late 80s, 90s. And so we have a thing in our family. When we say wet, we go wet. And Marty Pello, that's right. I think she had a bit of a thing for Marty Pello. As I think quite a few ladies did in those days. So, yeah, I can't remember any of those songs. I can't remember any of those songs offhand. Maybe you do. You can put them in the comments box below. While I'm kind of doing this and thinking of what on earth am I going to talk about while I'm doing this, I'm now adding a little bit of kind of burnt umber to make this a bit darker. And some of these bits, I'm just going to kind of sort of put spots in around in the kind of in the inner hubs, as it were. Like that. So again, this is all wet on wet. And now I'm going to add some blue. And please don't ask me what blue it is. That's two blues. Look, two different blues. With a bit of this pinky red. And that will give us a nice purple. And I want to get that all around the edge. And I'm going to be really kind of... I'm spotting and dropping it in there now. I'm wanting to get a nice... kind of hard edge to this, and being a water brush, the thing is that as you're going along, the water keeps flowing, and so you're losing intensity of colour. So you need to keep coming back. I'm going to put a few little spots in there as well. So you need to keep coming back and picking up a bit more. And we're really wanting this on the outside. Get that nice and neat and bring a few bits more in. So sort of building up, starting with the pale colour and then dropping in with that nice red. And then we're just sort of getting darker and darker and darker. So it's building, which really is the secret of watercolour. It's all about building. This is starting to look a little bit dry at the end here. It is a little bit. So in there. So yeah, keep going, don't stop. And a few more little bits down there, and a bit there and there. And I'm going to draw this leaf, I'll add a little bit of pink, and then I'm just going to add a little bit of yellow at the end, and maybe just to kind of lighten the end there a little bit. Now as it dries, it kind of loses some of that intensity. So you know, a lot of this is you can do this 100 times, draw 100 leaves, and each time you will learn something, and you think, oh, that could have been darker because it dries a little bit lighter. And you know, each time you do kind of learn stuff. So I probably shouldn't be doing this, so I'm just getting a little bit of this purpley sort of stuff and just kind of trying to give a little feeling of shape. But this is very, very thin color, it's very weak. So I'm just kind of, because the, you know, the leaves kind of mold around the shape of the veins that are going up the middle. Oh, that's a bit too much, isn't it? There we are, just wash that out a bit. And then finally, what I'm going to do is to clean this bit here. There's my tiny little sketching kit. Lots of people ask me about this, actually, and this is a very old set I gave my mother in about 1984. It's Winsor & Newton. The tin is Winsor & Newton. Well, all the colours are. But and she never really used it, and so she gave it to me. So it's quite an old tin. I don't think you can get them anymore. It's, you know, it's proper quality, old-fashioned quality. So I'm just painting clean water for a reason. And maybe have a bit in there. So now I'm going to pick up a bit of this neutral tint, and I'm going to just paint it in there and allow that just to flow and fade into the water there, so that you get a really soft edge. And there. And I don't think it's as soft as it could be. There. And then, and I think maybe we'll try and bring in a, so getting a little bit darker in underneath there and underneath there. And then I'm going to try and bring that kind of out into a more definite sort of shadow there. And I think we probably need a bit more shadow in there and something in there. And I am going to leave it at that. Now, if you are going to do your own version and you're really proud of it, then share it with a hashtag shoobydoodle on Instagram, Facebook or Twitter, so that I can find it. And maybe then I'll give you a heart and maybe even follow if you have a really interesting account. And then also I can make a great big video one day and share everybody's work. And that will be fun. But in the meantime, keep drawing, practice. And I'll see you next time. You take care now. Bye-bye.